People have, you know, they do carbon dosing, which is a biopellet reactor. People have refugiums to keep the nitrates down. People do more water changes and bigger water changes to keep the nitrates down. So you do sugar dosing to keep the nitrates down, to populate the bacteria so they take care of the nitrates and export them. What's the big deal, right? It's, yes, vacuum your sand. Yes, do your water changes. Yes, don't feed your fish too much. Yes, don't have too many fish in your aquarium. You got to do all these things, keeping the bio load down so there's not more nutrients, right? And don't go crazy. Don't feel sorry for your fish. Yes, you have to feed them, but don't feel sorry for them. If they're looking for a lot of extra food to eat, yeah, give it to them, you know. But don't feel sorry for them. Don't just feed them to feed them, you know. They'll survive. They can go a few days without eating. So you giving them one meal a day is fine. Some people do two. I feed them twice on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday in the morning, Saturday and Sunday at night. Once a night, Monday through Friday. And what is a biopellet reactor? Let me show you. Do I have some biopellets? I'm not going to do much editing. I just wanted to talk to you guys. All right, so here's how it works, right? I'm going to build this, but I thought I would film it first. These are biopellets that I got from Bulk Reef Supply. You see how they're like little pellets, right? So the idea is you're going to get a reactor, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to build one. And you're going to put 1 cup of pellets per, 50 gallons, yeah. So I'm going to use 2 cups of pellets for 100 gallons. I got a 125, I'm just going to do 100. So it looks like there will be enough for 2 cups. I think this was about $40. You've seen videos on this before. You're going to dump these into a reactor, which is filled with water. You're going to have a little pump in there that's going to gently churn these around. The bacteria is going to feed off of this, all right? And you don't have to do anything. You don't have to replace these. These will just go away. They'll dissolve after they're eaten down. You just have to replace them, I don't know, maybe once a year. All right, guys, so step one is done, I think. Check that out. It's kind of big, but I heard it needs to be big.
That's what she said.
So the pellets are gonna tumble. You're gonna have water up to here. I'll probably drill the hole here so the water can escape. But then this guy's gonna unscrew, like I said. You know, like Indiana Jones when he walks into the... That's awesome. Just found a new instrument for the studio, I think. I'm excited about this. Now we're gonna drill the holes. And then I got a uniseal for 1/4 inch. That's gonna go here where the pump's gonna go, and check this out. Got the little pump here. This is gonna go on here, the larger end. These are 1/4 inch. Gonna fit on like so. The smaller side is just right for 1/4 inch pipe. Yeah! And then that 1/4 inch pipe is going to go through this uniseal, which is gonna be in this. So that's how the water's gonna come from the sump. It's gonna flow into here. It's gonna go up here. It's gonna go out here, wrong way, through the purple pipe. Has to be purple to work. And it's gonna go through the uniseal into the tube, and it's gonna tumble, and then it's gonna go out, and it's gonna come back into the pump, sump. That's my plan. Gordon has plans. The cops have plans. I just do things. Do I look like a guy with a plan? I just do things. Here's my biopellet reactor. It looks really nice, man. This is what you're gonna need. I got the one from Milwaukee. It's a hole dozer, that's what they're called. It drills a perfect circle in wood or PVC, plastic, whatnot. And then you're gonna take your PVC pipe and push it through that seal So as the pump fills this with water, these biopellets are going to start to tumble, and then the water line is going to come up, and then water is going to escape out here back into your sump. Nitrates will be exported through the protein skimmer, which is also in the sump. This is going to be awesome. I'm really looking forward to it.
It is alive.
This is done. This pump is the Rio Plus 800. The biopellet reactor is 16 inches tall, and I've got the Rio Plus valve all the way open. There's a valve right there. You can control the amount of flow. I've got it all the way open for max. And as you can see, they're tumbling well. Alright? So if I would have gotten the pump beneath it, like the Rio 600 or whatever, I'm making that up, I don't know. I think there's a 600. It may work, but this is actually the perfect tumble. I got lucky with this pump. I'm going to throw this guy in my sump.